Thanks to Ford for powering our CES coverage.
Taking a look at the Droid 4. We've seen this guy. Heck, we've even had one of its non-working dummy units in the Techno Buffalo offices. Here we've got in its final production form. Let's go ahead and run through the specs and give you some first impressions. All right, so first and foremost, this is definitely the lightest droid. Much lighter in the hand than the outgoing Droid 4, but an outgoing Droid 3 rather. Big difference here though is the keyboard. I've never been the biggest fan of the previous generation droid's keyboard. This one did away with that sort of single film over a little bit of raises. These are actually individual keys, and you've got a full number row. If you look at it from the profile, it's a little bit of raised. There's a great amount of key throw. The keys here really feel nice. One of the better keyboards that I've used recently. One knock on it though, sliding mechanism is not spring loaded. So you gotta push it all the way up. So it is running Gingerbread. It's version 2.3.5. It's got a 1.2 gigahertz dual core CPU in here. It's got a 4-inch QHD display on the back of it. And it's got an 8-megapixel camera that can shoot 1080p video. See, it tells you right there. And it's got an LED flash, 16 gigs of storage built in. And of course, what's become a sort of hallmark of that Droid name is that QWERTY keyboard. So this is the original Droid, not a Droid Charge or a Droid Razer. This is just a straight up Droid. On the left-hand side, that's where your charging and HDMI out are gonna live. On the bottom, noise-canceling microphone. On the right-hand side, we've got volume up and down. On the top, power and lock button lives right in the middle. 3.5 millimeter headset jack and front-facing camera. Now, the phone feels pretty zippy and is very nicely spec'd and augmented by 1 gigabyte of RAM. It's got Motorola's, don't really call it modal blur anymore, with all kinds of widget configurations on here. Go ahead and show you some of these. Jump from home screen to home screen if you just hit the home button. Pick where you want. Let's go ahead and jump into settings and go check out About Phone. You can see that 2.3.5 to prove that I'm not a liar. Android 2.3.5. Presumably, though, we will see ice cream sandwich on this guy in the near future. You've got 4 capacitive buttons here at the bottom in sort of Motorola's reversed order. You got your menu, home, back, and search, and those do give you haptic feedback whenever you touch them. If you go back home, you've got a little bit of indicator down there at the bottom. Hopefully you can see. That'll show you what screen you're on. That'll move around between any of the 5 home screens that the Motorola Droid 4 has. So I'm John Rettinger from Techno Buffalo. Be sure to stay tuned for a full review of the Droid 4 and all of its QWERTY pack in action. I'll see you guys next video. Bye-bye.
No one likes the difficulty and precision needed when parallel parking. But when you use the Active Park Assist feature found on the Focus, you remove the stress by using ultrasonic sensors to identify an open parking spot. Pair this with the rear view camera and the car practically parks itself for you. Thanks to Ford for powering our CES coverage.